Maitaki. The question is that the motion be agreed to.
Madam Speaker.
I call the Honourable Alfred Nuttall.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, can I first of all say and declare and thank you for the speech from the Honourable Kamau Sepuloni, because the National Party will be supporting this bill. We see this as a bill that is of great importance and also signifies the relationship that we have. Can I first of all also acknowledge the Honourable Henry Puna, that's here, the Prime Minister of the Cook Islands, and also to Her Excellency Te Rumana Yala, also too, and thank you for being here. So, kia rana kōrua, no te reme ki rute te paramata, no Aotearoa. Madam Speaker, can I also acknowledge you as a fellow Kiwi of Cook Island descent as well. Today is a day that's a proud day that we can see a piece of legislation that benefits not only us for here in New Zealand, but also for those of our descendants back home and our families back home as well, both in the three nations of the realm. That's Cook Islands, Niue and Tokelau as well. And the special relationship has been signified that the Honourable Prime Minister Puna is here today when he was meant to be up at a cocktail function up in Auckland. I know, because I received the invitation. And as I saw him today, he said, actually, the other ministers can attend to this, but it's important that he be here today for this piece of legislation. So can I acknowledge the fact of your presence being here? Because it was also you back in 2015 that came, Prime Minister Puna, along with the Premier of Niue, Toke Taulangi, that when I was chairing the Social Service Select Committee, we talked about the portability of the pension back in 2015. And I thank you because you came, and I'm sure that it'd be one of the few occasions where the head of a nation, the Prime Minister himself, and in this case the Premier and Prime Minister, came to a New Zealand Select Committee to present a submission. And when you presented the submission, you first of all acknowledged the fact that this had begun. I want to acknowledge, and you acknowledge, the Honourable Murray McCulley, because the conversations have been long, but there came to a point where there was a time in which it was time to actually act upon this and put this through. So you acknowledge the portability of the pension, and in this case, the Social Assistance Residency Qualification Legislation Bill, but you also to petition the aspect of the 10 and 5-year rule, which is now before us in this bill. And it's to remove that 5-year rule. Your petition to us, if I can remember quite clearly, was the fact is that in order to ensure that we address the issues of depopulation back in all the nations of the realm, that it was important that we have the ability for our people who've come here, who've worked here for many years and have been present in the country, that they be able to come back and to contribute both socially, economically and culturally back to the nation as well. So I want to acknowledge and honour you for your passion, for your advocacy at that time, because I believe that's also led us to where we are here today as well. And in this bill, and I want to acknowledge the current government of the day who've continued to take that on, and as the advocacy was, let's now remove the 5 years. So what it intentionally says is that those three nations of the realm, those that are of Cook Island, Niue and Tokelau descent, can return home. They can actually bring something back to those local economies, to those local communities as well, and I think that's significantly important to what we're hearing in our communities. If I think back that there were times when we think, what is the contribution of Pacific peoples? And I want to acknowledge that we've now been able to highlight the significant contribution back in World War I, and it wasn't 2 or 3 years ago, we were acknowledging the centenary celebrations of New Zealand's 100 years. And all the way back into that, we actually realised that actually we had a part to play. Pacifica people were represented. I want to acknowledge the 147 Niue soldiers that were represented back in World War I. The almost 500 Cook Island soldiers that were represented. There were also members from Samoa, from Tokelau, and also too from Tonga as well. In all, they say in World War I, there would have been approximately 1,000 Pacific people that were represented. They had fought for the country. Under British rule, but because that they believed it was important to make a contribution. And I mention that because part of what we're talking about today is honouring the contribution of Pacifica people that they've made into New Zealand. And it's only fair that the fact is that this bill is not only dealing with those in regards to the superannuation, but also those who've been veterans. And that's why I want to acknowledge the veteran contribution of those who've made their contribution many times. In fact, I see my good colleague and friend here, the Honourable Penny Henare, and it was only last year where we had the enactment where the first contingent of the Rarotonga contingent came here in 1917, and it was actually in this chamber, where we had Papa Te Puawe, who came along. His father was part of the 45 that were there. And I want to acknowledge the Honourable Penny Hinare, because on behalf of his grandfather, who was there at that time as the minister, actually had the mihi towards them. And it was a powerful, it was an emotional, it was a spiritual moment, because, again, it recognised the contribution that our Pacifica people made. So I'm proud here today to acknowledge that, the importance of this, because what this bill does is in acknowledging, in a way, to say that the contribution, not only from the past, but even in the present, for those who've contributed 10 years or more, can now return back into the Pacific nations, into those realm countries, and to contribute back as well. The special issues that are here is that there are three different types of superannuation in New Zealand. There's the Reciprocal Social Security Agreement, there's the Special Portability, and the General Portability. This particular piece of legislation comes under the Special Portability, and that's important. Again, it recognises the relationship, but it means the fact is that, again, that after those who've been here, contributed to society over 10 years before turning 50, can now return back. And what we've heard time and time again, that that's made a difference into those nations, contributing into their villages, giving back into their families as well. And I think that's going to be important. Prime Minister Puna, you also too yesterday in the old legislative chamber, in fact, just parallel to here, you talked about the importance of graduation. And I want to acknowledge that, because when we see our Pacific nations, the only way that we can graduate, that we can mature, that we can move on, is when we have the opportunities to grow the economy, but also to bring back those who've been the diaspora, is what we call them, Cook Islanders who've lived abroad, who've gained some experience and some expertise, and New Hawaiians and Tokelauans who can come back and then and make their contribution. And I want to thank you for that, because I think there truly is a statement of leadership in our Pacific nations, to say that even as small Pacific nations, we can have a contribution, that we can move from a sense of dependency, and even though as nations of the realm, you are self-governing and in free association, it's truly a mark of leadership and maturity when, as small Pacific nations, we desire to actually graduate, to have some sense of dependency as well. And inside of that, I know that one of the questions that I asked from the floor yesterday was about how can we grow that connectivity, and previously we used to have an overseas seat. You, in true form and in humour, said, well, what we do is that we supplant Cook Islanders into the New Zealand Parliament. And I want to acknowledge the Deputy Speaker here as well. But I think what you were also too alluding to is that there are a number of Cook Islands and New Orleans and Tokelauans who have succeeded and have done well in our society. If I think about, it was only just last week, we were there to welcome Adrian Orr, who is now the Governor of the Reserve Bank in New Zealand. And that's quite a significant role. And even though he's from Aotearoa ascent, well, you can't all be perfect. He's not from Aitutaki, Mangae or Pukapuka. That's okay. But what's more important is that he's a Cook Islander that's able to be in a position of influence. And there are many others. I hope that what this bill will do is that it will encourage more of our Pacifica people to say this, with the experience that they have learnt, with the expertise that they can offer, that they will return home. And I know that the Honourable Carmel Cipollone and I and others were on the Pacific Mission, and when we were in Niue, what I was really encouraged is that there are a number of young people and families who said that we're coming back home. We're coming back home because we believe that our countries are a better place to raise our children. It's a way of connecting back to our families and to our villages. And so already we see that people are returning back. This piece of legislation, I believe, is another way of creating a pathway that will not only encourage it, but it will also enable that ability as well. Because for a number of them, what they often say, that what holds them back from returning is the fact of their parents. And now they'll have the ability to be able to support their parents as they return back. The legislation will mean that they no longer need to be present or resident in Aotearoa, in New Zealand. They can actually continue to be living and working and contributing back in those nations of the realm, and that becomes significantly important as well. So, Madam Speaker, can I say that it's a proud day to be able to speak to this bill. I know that for you and I, it is proud to be able to see that not only for the Cook Islands, but for Niue and for Tokelau, many of those who will see this as a significant part, and more importantly, something that we join right across the House in supporting, we support this piece of legislation to the House.
Now, before I call the Honourable Member on the next call, I just want to make clear that although the previous speaker did make mention of the chair in his debate, I know that he was referring to the presence in the gallery of the Honourable Henry Puna, Prime Minister of the Cook Islands, and the delegation that's there. So I was lenient towards you, but I would encourage members in their contributions to ensure that they do not bring the speaker into the debate. I call the Honourable Penny Henare.
Tēnā koe e te māngai o te whare, ka noho a hau ki roto i te reo Māori mo te wahanga tuatahi o taku kōrero.